I just wanted to walk you through some of the features of our new universal short throw arm. One of the unique things you'll notice right off the bat is our wall plate. It's got a very unique design. First is, ours is one of the few wall plates on the market that doesn't care if there's a stud right in the center of a whiteboard. That's going to be a lot of installations where you don't have a stud right in the center. So if you have a stud in the middle, great, we'll use it. If not, we can grab on 12s, 16s, 18s, 24-inch centers. That's both wood and steel studs as well as concrete. Hardware to do that is all in the hardware packs. You'll also notice that it stands off the wall a little bit. This is utilizing something we call our gearbox family of equipment enclosures. There's little doors on the sides, and it actually allows you to put in some kind of control systems. You could do something like a small form factor PC, or in this case a Mac Mini, and you could just slide it right inside there and close the door. You can actually secure it. Or you could do something like a control system, like in this case we have a Crestron QM series quick media device, AMX, SP controls, you name it, you can put that in there. It actually has quite a bit of storage capacity. You can also fit power and AC back there. There's a port right here in the middle where you can then dress out all your cables. The next piece of this installation is the short throw arm itself. It's fully adjustable in distance there. In the standard configuration, it adjusts from 7 inches from the wall to 27 inches from the wall. We also make an extension that allows you to go all the way up to 67 inches off the wall. So to hook this on, it's much like hanging a coat on a coat rack. You simply take the little hooks and you slide them over the top there until they drop in the slot. And then away you go. So very simple and stable. There are actually two security screws that hook on to the inside, which allows you to not take it off anymore. But it's very durable. You can support up to 300 pounds on it, so no worries there. Again, the carriage right here is fully adjustable in depth, anywhere from 7 inches to 27 inches. All your cables would then be routed through the body of this, and depending on where your projector is located, you would bring your cables out through one of these side ports. And there's actually an end port right here that you can dress the cables right out the end. So if your projector's right out the end. Once you've got your location of how far in, you know, measured from the wall, how far your projector needs to be, you would go ahead and tighten this down. I'm gonna do this really quickly. Again, all of these use our security hardware. So that requires a special Allen key. We utilize the PDS series mount for this, as we find it to be the most versatile, and it has the most adjustment in terms of tilt, roll, and yaw adjustment. So it's easy. I already had it pre-mounted onto, this is a Mitsubishi short throw. I already had it pre-installed. It just hooks right on, then you can simply adjust. And if you keep all of the center positions nice and tight, this will adjust for you very nicely. It's very simple to hold and register tilt functionality and roll functionality. It's finger adjustment and it stays where you'd left it. Some things might get really loose when you're moving them around and then they tighten up at the very end. Not so in this case. It's very easy to do very small, finite adjustments, and it will hold that registration. And because the PDS base box has 12 different points of positive contact, it seems like a lot of screws to tighten, but in actuality, this will save you a lot of recalls later on, because this will not loosen. It will not come out of registration once you tighten all 12 of those positions. So we have the PDS base box mounted on there. We've adjusted our items. The last piece is that we've ran all our cables. The end actually has a decorative nose cover so that no one sees any unsightly cables down here at the end. You would take this and simply slide it over the end. There's again a security screw that holds it in place. And then the last piece is we make these little pop-on covers. And what this does is it actually goes over the wall plate. We do allow you some lateral shift here, so just in case you need some finite movements, you can slide this just so it's exactly centered on your whiteboard. And then when you're all done, tighten those lags or the wood screws or concrete anchors and pop on these covers. Just like that. And you're good to go.